And then we lay it down in the dining room in the hallway. We had a big hall, the house had a big old hall. Front of the hall was sitting in the back of the hall where you had a sofa and thing like that. My brother stayed down there. Then we had a big dining room and a big old kitchen. We had a large kitchen.
Was your mom a good cook?
Huh?
Was your mom a good cook?
Oh, yeah. That's all she wanted to do.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's all she wanted to do. And they made the green woman, and then she made rolls every week. They made hot rolls, more than two sometimes, but in they made them every week, sometimes twice a week.
Now, how old were you when you finished high school?
I was 17 going on 18.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And you went to work right after that, or did you do anything?
Well, I was sickly like, and I didn't do nothing for a while, and you know, just did day's work and found a little work at a restaurant and things like that. Yeah.
So how did you get the job at Philip Morris?
Made it. My girlfriend in the next block, and she carried me down there. She called me and told me to come down there. And then from then on, they gave me a few hours, about 5 or 6 hours, and then later on, I just got hired on down there.
Did they pay pretty well?
Yeah, Philip Morris had to go according to the scale of Philip Morris and thing like that. See, Philip Morris was the highest paying cafeteria type during that time. Because, you know, the back of the people was making more money, and Philip Morris was the highest cafeteria type. He was paying more than any other cafeteria.
So how many years did you work in the cafeteria?
About 29.
Okay, so you retired from Philip Morris?
Yeah, uh-huh.
What kind of work did you do in the cafeteria? Were you cooking or serving or both?
Cooking. Yeah, so later years started cooking.
So what kind of hours did you work? Did you work early or late?
Yeah, sometimes from 6 to 2 and sometimes from 7 to 2:30 or 3. Yeah.
But you never had to work all night?
No, we never worked at all night. I have worked at 3 o'clock and went back at 5:30 and just served from 5:30 to 9:30. Just one the night shift that 6 weeks full of us had, or 6 weeks tobacco run, and the people just worked 6 weeks, and then we'll go back over there and serve the people just supper and as long as we'll be served supper, but that was already repaired. You're just going and serve it, and been off at 9:30.
Now, were you a smoker? I know they used to give out cigarettes.
No, I never smoked. No, I never smoked.
You were too worried because you were kind of sickly.
Yeah. I was in there and seen people that were working in there and didn't know, all you did was see a shadow.
Mm-hmm.
I done worked that, went through that, and all I could see was a shadow that people that was working in there. That's how much dust over at the stimmery.
Mm-hmm.
But not at the other factory, not really to make the because down McFadden and down manufacturing, you could eat off the floor because they got them hardwood floors, and you could see your face on it. That's how the factory inside. But over at the stimmery, years back, but it got better as the years went on. But when I first went over there, all you know was a person working out there. We stand in the mural, in the window, and look out there, and all you just see was a shadow of a person, because that's how much dust was out there he was working in.
Mm-hmm. Now, were your parents smokers?
My father, no, my mama didn't smoke at
okay.
all. No, she never smoked at all. My father did.
So you see.
Yeah, my father did, and my brother. But I had my older sister and my friend, they didn't smoke. My older husband, none of them didn't smoke. And I never dealt with, I've never been around many boys that really did most whole lot of smoking.
Mm-hmm. But did you get the free cigarettes like everybody else did?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I got this free cigarettes.
You just give them away to people.
Give them away to people. Yeah.
Now, was it only black people that worked in the cafeteria?
No, we had a few white.
Okay.
We had white in there.
Did you get paid the same money?
Yeah, you get paid. We had, you know, grill cook, the line service, and that's how you, the scale was. Nobody in there got the same thing, you know, the same rating. The head cook, you know, and thing like that. And see, we had a baker and stuff like that, so everybody, you know, got a different thing in the bakery. Baker and the salad girls and all like that.
So you got paid according to your job?
Yeah, you got paid according to your job.
So they were ahead of a lot of other companies.
Huh?
They were ahead of their time.
Yeah, they was ahead of their time. Because they was the oldest one during that time was paying, you know, above minimum wages, you know. Mm-hmm. They had to pay according to what, and you had to be belong to the union, so if you was in the cafeteria, they had a union, so you had to belong to the union too. Yeah, so the cafeteria, it was the only one that the cafeteria, you know, had union and everything like that. Going to Philip Morris Union.
Did you work at Philip Morris on Commerce Street, or was it somewhere else?
I worked at every one of them that they had. the one on Main Street, and the one on 7 in Commerce, and Manufacturer Research, Stimmer, McFadden, so many different names, yeah. They down at the Manufacturer, down on Bell Road, they got so many different planks down there. Yeah, they got so many different planks.